Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming to our electronic music concert. We are going to be your host tonight. My name is Sam.
I'm Alex, and we're going to be hosting the CSM electronic music concert for this spring semester. So a little overview. Tonight is going to be a showcase of the portfolio and sound synthesis classes. So there's going to be a pretty big range of talents you're going to see. And just to segue, I'm going to ask Sam to introduce the first performer.
Yes, our first performer tonight is Marcel Rulliford with his piece titled Stay. I hope you enjoy, and let's give a round of applause for Marcel. Give another round of applause for Marcel.
Yeah, that was definitely a fantastic piece. Marcel definitely has a knack for creating ambient soundscapes, so definitely going places with that. Our next piece is titled Acid, and it is by Monica Cuenca and her counterpart, Joey Zimmerman.
So my piece is called Acid. It's all about the frustration of wanting to change yourself or be overly kind to another person without receiving much in return. And I wrote this about an old friend of mine who did exactly that and just took too much while I was giving way too much. So. Thank you.
So not exactly as planned, but still a good take. And I just want to thank my friend Joey here for learning that guitar part in a single week. I was planning on doing this all by myself, but he really provided the support and like moral support that I needed. So yeah, thank you guys for coming. And yeah, thank you.
That was a very honest and heartfelt performance, so let's give Joey and Monica another round of applause.
So our next performance is going to be done by Jude Sansor, but it's a little different because we're gonna have our lovely and wonderful theater manager, Diego.
I think it's Baldonado.
Diego will be doing a improv light show over Jude's piece. So please enjoy.
Yo, it's like this, man.
Thank you. That's what's on my mind when I toss in my sleep.
Why don't we have Jude come up so we can give her a round of applause? Well, I think we're ready to go for our next performer, who is?
Oh yeah, we have next up, in similar fashion like the last performance, we have Tony Himuli with his work of art titled Tuned Up, and we're gonna have Diego Baldonado also doing the light effect, so it's also going to be improv. So let's give a round of applause for that.
Thank you.
Yeah, let's give another round of applause for Tony Mueli and Diego Baldonado. Oh, here's Tony. Tony, what do you have to say about your piece?
Say again?
What do you have to say about your piece?
My piece was inspired by the composer Yuzo Koshiro and his work on the Maximum Tune video game series. And I'd also like to say thank you everyone for coming out, and I hope you have a great rest of your night. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. I've known Sandy since the Musical Interfaces class, and he's got that creativity. I'm sorry, they have got that creativity. Very important. And Sandy's piece is called Darker Skies.
So let's put a round of applause for Sandy's piece.
Give another round of applause to Sandy Napkin and their piece, Darker Skies. Where's Sandy? Sandy, if you can come up on stage, we'd like to have you on stage so that everyone... Oh, there you are.
So our next performer is Angie Iwaki, and she's gonna be presenting a section of a podcast that I believe she edited, and she's actually gonna come up and talk about it for a little bit and describe what's going on.
Hi, I heard about Natalie Nakase. She's first female NBA coach. She's not a head coach, but she's an NBA coach. She was an assistant coach for the LA Clippers, and I just thought her story was really interesting. And as I delved more into it for my podcast, I learned a lot about the history of the Japanese American basketball leagues and the history on the West Coast. And I spoke with Chris Komai, who's one of the founders of the Nikkei Heritage Basketball Association, for this interview. So here it is.
So let's give it all up for Angie's piece.
Natalie tells the story that her parents were trying to get her to go to Japanese language school, which she hated. And I don't know anyone who liked going to Japanese language school. And so Gary said to her, well, if you don't go to Japanese school, then you're going to have to come with me when we go to basketball practice with your older sisters. And she goes, okay. And so she kind of got on that track, right, in which she was exposed. I always think there is an advantage for younger siblings sometimes. If your older siblings are participating and you wanna participate too, but you're younger, but you are competitive. So she had the competitiveness, she had access, she was given the opportunity by her father. But I asked Gary, I said, so Gary, what did you do to make Natalie more competitive? And he looked at me and said, nothing. It was just the way she was. And I asked Jamie Haguia's father, I asked him the same thing. He said, what did you do for Jamie? Nothing. So it just was in them. What happened is they had that in them, but it was allowed to develop because she was able to play basketball from the time she was young. What Natalie said, what helped her is that there was a woman before her who played at UCLA, a woman named Teiko Nishi, who played in the 1980s. And because she saw Teiko play, then Natalie thought, I could do that, right? And this is so important for us as a community, that you see this and then you see them do it, and kids automatically think, if they don't see it, they think, well, maybe there's a reason why you won't see anyone who looks at me and it's not for me. But once they see it, they go, wait, Teiko's playing. So Natalie thought, I could play. And what's interesting is there's a younger woman named Allison Taka who says the same thing about having seen Natalie play at UCLA. And Allison ended up playing at UCLA as well. So you see this continuation. But like you said, you need someone to break through there in the beginning, and that's what happened. The interesting thing about Natalie is that she had the desire to be a coach. Because she got hurt and she was playing semi-pro ball in I think in Europe, in Germany or something like that, when she was hurt, she began sitting on the bench and began thinking about, well, maybe I could do this as a coach, right? I have, you know, sort of the background, the knowledge and things like that. And she actually had an opportunity to coach in Japan, which is even more amazing because, you know, Japan is still pretty, you know, male-centric. And yet she was able to coach on a team there as well, which I think helped her have the confidence to come here and, like you said, become an assistant coach for the Clippers. And, you know, if you ever see those pictures of her, you know, and there's some Clippers player who's 6'10", and she's 5'2", and he's kind of bending down, listening to her as she's talking to him. But see, that goes back to me as a young man, gaining the confidence in myself and believing that I can do this, right? And I know basketball well enough that I can make a contribution at any level, and that's what Natalie's done. I couldn't be more happy that she got this job working for the WNBA for the Las Vegas Aces. She is assistant coach. The Aces won the WNBA championship this year. I can imagine that must have been an incredible thrill for her. Hopefully there'll be other opportunities for her coming forward. I mean, if you looked on the bench, right, she would be sitting next to the head coach every game, which suggests that Natalie is being groomed to be a coach somewhere else at some time. But all this, to me, does lead back to, you know, she grew up in Orange County, you know, played in the leagues, had two older siblings, had a father who was heavily involved in community leagues. And that background gave her the sort of the platform for her to get to the highest level if there were somebody there who would see her for what she really was. You know, as someone, first as a player, she had to walk on at UCLA, and like you said, she was 5'2", right? But she was tough, right? She was smart and tough. She wouldn't back down. You knock her down, she gets back up. But she represented all those things. This is kind of sort of the ideal story that comes out of our league.
So I would like to excuse myself. I don't think I properly gave the podcast a title. It's titled The Asian Fail Podcast. So why don't we give another round of applause for Angie's piece?
Okay, so next up we have, for number 8, we have Ghost Chase, performed by Connor Fitzpatrick. Yeah! Just a little plot twist. He's actually one of the sound guys here, so give it up to Connor.
Yeah.
So next up, our next performers are going to be Tom and Ben Yaniv with their piece, Diana's Final Cry.
I will say, though, so for... I had class with Tom, so I had... The last class I had with Tom was last semester. That was also musical interfaces. And I feel like ever since then, I've seen Tom develop his, like, creative vision a lot. Like, it's just developed drastically. So I'm really excited for you guys to see this, because this is, like... I think this is peak Tom right now. Like, seriously. So... Yeah, this is gonna be great. I'm not gonna give you any spoilers though, so don't count on it. Oh, actually, I think we're good to go. So
yeah, we're good to go. So let's give it up for Ben and Tom Yaniv.
Hi, my name is Tom Yaniv. My name is Ben, and we're brothers. And the name of my song is Diana's Final Cry. So originally the song's intent was to create a story. But I never actually wrote the lyrics until, like, the last day, so the song kind of became its own thing, and then I've recently started getting into witchcraft, so I decided to base the character off of the moon goddess Diana, and base essentially the song. It kind of encompasses the idea that since the moon goddess kind of resembles, like, nature and fertility, so I kind of wanted to take that and be like, okay, well, these are things that humans are disrespecting. So Diana is like dying. People aren't believing in her abilities. And so Diana is having her final cry because, like, you know, the earth is dying. So it's kind of like a morbid song.
This time you're on your own. Welcome. She's lost in the world alone.
Let's do another round of applause for Tom and Ben Yaniv. So as you can tell, the other MC is gone. He has just disappeared. But luckily, that's because his piece is up next. So for this piece, let's say his full name, Sam Nadelberg. He will be presenting a video piece that is also accompanied by his music, so you could say that he made both of those things. So that's really cool. So let's give a round of applause to Sam.
Let's all give it up for our very own MC, Sam Nadel, for Static Mellows.
So I think we noticed that Christine came out instead of Alex. That's because she's setting up her piece now in the background while I'm talking. So why don't we go, let's see. Alex is like one of our last pieces. So I think I want to say before we continue, I want to thank everyone who has came, and I want to say that we all appreciate that you all came to see us perform tonight. We've been working all day to make this happen. It's been hard. We're all a little bit tired. Yeah. But I think it's coming out pretty well. What do you guys think? Yeah! Our next piece is Alexandria's piece, When the Rain Stops Falling. The video is done by Maya Chan, so please enjoy. And let's give it up for Alexandria.
Concord 78 degrees. Gold Coast reporting 66. Livermore's at 80. We have Redwood City at 72. San Jose 71. And downtown San Francisco 57 degrees. Traffic and weather together on the 8th on All News 106.9 and AM 740 KCBS. KCBS News Time 8:19 as our news watch continues. The impacts of record high inflation can be seen virtually everywhere.
You know, they say it's weird that people start to look like their spouses.
But that was Alexander. Let's give her another round of applause. Alexandra, why don't you come out? Well, while I'm waiting, let's see. What were we talking about before?
I'm coming.
Oh, never mind. There she is.
Hello.
Let's give her another round of applause, guys.
So my friend Maya that made the visuals is actually not here tonight because she's sick, but I definitely want to give her an extra round of applause for making those visuals. The next performance that we have is called Real Love by Tommy Consuni. You guys are in for a treat, like for sure.
So we're gonna have some final words afterwards, but please enjoy Tommy's piece. We've worked really hard all night, so we really hope that we put on a good show for all of you guys. And once again, we're gonna have some like extra little closing lines from ourselves, and I think our professor is gonna come up to talk for a bit too. Let's give a round of applause for Tommy.
Hi, I'm Tommy C. The name of my piece is Real Love. For the musical intent, imagine the cockiest yet smoothest pickup line you've ever heard. That's my piece.
Guys, don't chase, can't do it for you. Yeah, I know what you're waiting for.
Girl, I'ma give you something that you never had before.
And you know it would be so good.
And I'ma give you something that I know you'll never forget.
I know what you want. Let me give you that. No, it would be so good.
Real, 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 real love.
I will be good to you.
I'd rather be with you, boo.
Yeah. Only you.
Yeah, I'd rather be with you.
I'll change your life if you stay, and you can tell I don't. Lovelies, they got nothing on you. I swear I'm gonna go out of your attitude. Cause I'm not gonna be here for love.
Girl, I'm gonna give you something that you never had before.
I know what you're looking for.
And I'ma give you something that I know you'll never forget.
It would be so good.
Real, 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 real love.
I will be good to you. Break down now. Sounds so soulful, don't you agree?
Yeah.
I got a question.
Do you want this real love? I'll give you this real love. Do you want this real love? I'll give you this real love.
So take it right now.
Real,
wanna give you that
real, 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 real love.
I know what you're looking for.
I'ma give you that real,
girl, you like this real,
real
love.
Real,
I'ma give you this real,
real love. You know what would be so good? I'm talking that
real,
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 real, real
love.
One final round of applause for Tommy. And we've come to the end of our show tonight, but we'd like all the performers and stage members, crew members, to come on stage and say goodnight to everybody.
And so we can give them another round of applause.
Yeah, can we get all the performers out here on stage? I see you all hanging out back there. Come on out.
Yeah!
Can we get everybody? A little quicker. Everyone, thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you for supporting these artists and all their hard work this semester and live music. We really appreciate it. I'd also like to thank Professors Adria Adi and Brenda Hutchinson, as well as our theater manager, Diego, and all of the College of San Mateo, as well as the Creative Arts Department, and all of these students. Take a bow. Justin. Thank you, Justin. Also up in the booth still. Right. And please enjoy the rest of your evening. Feel free to join us out in the courtyard for some beverages and snacks if you'd like to hang out for a little while and talk with all of us here. Thank you. Good night.